All right, class CIS 270, CCNA 1 class. Got one lab here that kind of ramps things up a notch from where we've from what we've been doing previously. Netacad lab 1193 for CCNA 1. All right, so in this lab, you can see the layout here. The topology diagram. Let me bring up the other instructions. I just worked through this lab. Actually, I worked through it yesterday afternoon, and I've kept this running on my computer here so I can record a quick video to you to give you some tips on how to get through this one. All right, so one thing you're going to want to do for sure with this is go ahead and create a spreadsheet that looks exactly like this addressing table right here. You could do it, print this out and do it manually by writing the information down. But either way, you're going to want to populate this entire IP address and subnet mask and default gateway for the ones that need it so that you have it available when you need to configure things. The configuration on this one is really low. There's only like a handful of things you have to configure, but in order to do any of that, you need to do the calculations to figure out this information here, right? So there's also another area in here, a table that you're going to want to go ahead and create. So I created both of these on the same spreadsheet, but you're going to want to document these the subnets that you come up with, the subnet description, and also I'm going to show you a couple of steps to get you started on this, and then I think you should be able to take it from there to finish up. So let me show you how it goes. All right, so all right, they give you, and I also want to point out that you may not, when you run this lab, may not have this subnet right here, and it may in these number of hosts. They may vary on your lab. I've done this a couple of times, and each time I reset it, it gives different information. That doesn't matter. Once I show you how to get started with this, you can do this either way. So that shouldn't be a worry. All right, so let me, so here you're examining the network requirements. You're determining the number of subnets needed. So they kind of tell you right here, based on the topology, let me kind of show you here. So room 114 LAN, this one right here, requires 7 hosts. Room 279 LAN, 15. Room 312 LAN has 29 hosts. So that's this one here. And then you got the last one, room 407 LAN. That's 58 hosts. All right, so your LANs may be named something else, but there will likely be 4 LANs, and they'll be connected to 2 different routers like this in your lab. My routers in this lab are called Branch 1 and Branch 2. I've seen them called Customer Location 1, Customer Location 2. I've seen a few different things. That doesn't matter. Just follow the thing. And then in this one, we have some PC, one PC for each LAN. Labeled PC A, B, C, and D. Each LAN has a PC, right? So that helps with the labeling and using the matrix to complete or the spreadsheet to complete. So, all right, so we know what we're required. We have been given a subnet to use. So with this information, we can get started. But you want to read through this, the rest of this here too, just so you know how to get started. So they ask you some questions right here, which you'll be calculating all of this, which subnet mask will accommodate the number of IP addresses required for room 114. All right, so if you look for room 114 up here, you see that's 7, so it's a low number of addresses needed. But it you need so the subnet mask would be a higher number. All right, and then you work on that for each one. I've calculated that already. I've got the calculations here in this spreadsheet just so I can keep up with them. And I want to go through the first couple of ones to show you how I did this, right? I'm not requiring you to answer the questions to submit, but going through this on your own and answering these questions will help you as you work your way through it. So in part two, we're going to divide this provided subnet here, that network, into, so we're going to break it down for each LAN. And then we've got to do first, second, third, fourth, and then a fifth subnet, which we're going to use as the link between branch one and branch two, right? So we have to do that. And it actually tells us, we're going to document it, and it's document the addressing scheme. So there's somewhere here, there's a key to this here I wanted to show you. Let me make sure I'm finding it here. All right, so use the first subnet to accommodate the largest LAN. I want you to see that. And the second largest, the third largest. So I want you to do in order of how big the LANs are. So that means you would start by subnetting for 58. The second largest would be 29, 15, and then 7. And then for the branch-to-branch one here at the bottom, you only need two addresses for that one. So that would definitely be the smallest. So that would be the fifth one you're calculating for. All right, so let's calculate for the largest LAN first. So we're going to calculate for LAN 407, which needs 58 hosts. All right, so I'll bring up what I've got here. So LAN 407 with 58 hosts. So we're starting out with an address that we're provided by the instructions. And we need 58 hosts. Let me bring that back up. All right, 58, and we've got 192.168.72.0. So I got the calculator here. All right, so 72.0. All right, with this subnet mask info calculator. All right, so we need 58 hosts. Yep. All right, so with this, I've got the subnet that we're starting with here, and we got two things we can choose. We can choose the number of subnetworks we want or number of hosts. So if you choose the number of hosts, it's going to get us what we want. So we need 58 hosts. I'm going to have to pick 64 to accommodate that. That'll give us enough to fit. 32 is too little. 64 is enough. So I'm going to choose 64 and I'm going to calculate. All right, that is going to give us everything we need. It's going to give us our subnet mask 255.255.192, right? And our network address is 0, which we kind of started with that. And our broadcast address is 63. From this, we can calculate what our first host is, our last host is. So in this case, our first host available would be .1. Our last host would be the broadcast address -1, which would be .62. So we got our first host, our last host. We also have to calculate for our second host here, which is easy enough because if our first host is .1, our second host is .2, right? So they've given you a way to capture that, or a suggestion on how to capture that with this table down here. So I've done that in the spreadsheet. So this is what it shows. So the room 407 subnet, I've got my network address, my subnet mask, my first host, and my broadcast address, right? You could go ahead and make a column for your last host, but we know our last host is our broadcast address -1. So, easy enough. All right. So, so now you just need to calculate that and I'll show you, for each one. So if we go and I'll do one more of these, and then I'll show you how I take this information and just turn it into fill out the whole table. All right. So for LAN 312, we need 29 hosts. All right. So I'm going to go to my calculator. But before I go, I'm going to figure out what would my, I'll go there now. So I need 29 hosts. I'm going to go to the calculator. All right, so I got to figure out what address I need to start with, right? So if my broadcast address For the one I just calculated is .63. My next network will start with 64. Right, so then I just need to figure out how many hosts I'm going to choose. So I need 29 hosts. 32 will actually accommodate that. That'll give me enough to accommodate 29 hosts and a broadcast and a network address, right? So that's good for us. So I'm going to calculate that. And you'll see that my it calculates my subnet mask. It gives me my network address and my broadcast address. In order to make that easier to keep up with, you go ahead and populate your table with that. Network address, broadcast address, and subnet mask. Information that you're going to need to do any configuration and to complete this table of addresses here. Go ahead and do that for the next two LANs as well, using the number of hosts from the instructions. The last one, we get down to where our next network address is. Our next subnet starts with .144, and we need to calculate for the branch-to-branch link. So that'll be where it will be configured on each router's serial interface so that the routers can communicate to each other. So we only need one address for branch one and one address for branch two. So that's only two hosts that we need. So in order to calculate that, I'll just show you how I did that. I'm going to start with 144. Because that, once you do the other two LANs, it brings you to that and next in the network. And I'm going to calculate for four hosts. Four hosts because you got to allow for the network address and the broadcast address. So I'm going to calculate that. Excuse me. And we get 144 as the network. 147 is a broadcast. 145 would be our first host available. 146 would be our second host available. We only need two, so that works. All right, so inside the instructions, you have this addressing table here. Well, see, it's largely blank. So we need to populate this so that we know how to complete it. So this is how you go about that. So I'm going to go ahead and show you the populated table here. And I'm going to show you, let's see, the topology diagram. Let me bring that up. All right, so you need to assign the IP addresses to the correct location, right? So gig 00 on branch one, these are in, or they're configured kind of the way Netacad usually does this, you know, top to bottom, right to left. So, or left to right, excuse me. So room 114 is the subnet we want to start with. So we calculated room 114 over here. This is the addressing for it. So then if the network address is 128, the first host is 129. So if you can see over here, I went ahead and moved that information from my first calculations over here to populate the table so I know where to configure it. So 129 and its subnet mask, I configure there. There is no default gateway for this one because it is a router. It will become the default gateway for other things. As you can see, it happens here a couple of times. All right, moving on to gig 01 off of branch one, that is room 279. Room 279, my first host address is .97. So I move that here along with its appropriate subnet mask. You do that, and I'll go ahead and do the serial interface. All right, so in our branch one to branch two link, our first host available is .145. So we're using .145 here with its subnet mask that we calculated for. Skipping down to this one here, our next serial interface, the instructions walk you through populating this table one step at a time. But just so you can see, The other interface on this other branch 2 router over here, we're configuring it with the second address. But that's something that is used to connect these two networks together, or these two routers together. All right, then from there, the instructions have you configuring the, setting up the, or allocating the IP address for the various switches. They want you to use the second address in each subnet to configure on each switch. So you go ahead and calculate that, and populate this with the information. So for room 407, if the first host is .1, then the second host is .2. Go ahead and populate for the subnet mask and the default gateway. And keep in mind, I am not requiring you to turn this in for a grade. You simply have to complete the, just like you do on any packet tracer, you're doing a completion and you're getting, you're submitting the percentage, right? You'll check the results and you'll submit this, right? A screenshot of this, whatever works for you. But in order to be able to accomplish this, you're going to have to calculate these things. You don't know what questions are going to ask, and you need to know this information, right? So they have you use the second address in the subnet for the switch, and they want you to use the last address in the subnet, the address just before the broadcast, for each PC. So you want to go ahead and populate that information with its appropriate default gateways. And then I'll show you in the instructions here. Let's see. You get to the point where once you get all that stuff calculated and populated in the table, then you can actually start configuring some stuff. So let me show you that. Down here, it works you through every bit of this, right? All right, part 3, it'll tell you most of the IP addressing is already configured on this network. Implement the following steps to complete the address configuration. So they want you to configure the steps 1 through 4 right here. Configure the IP addressing on the branch 1 router. So they're only requiring you to do one router's LAN interfaces. Configure the IP addressing on the room 312 switch, including the default gateway. And then they want you to configure addressing on one PC. And once you get those done, as long as you configure them with the proper addressing that you've calculated in the tables, you'll be up at 100%. You can do the verify connectivity just so you can see how well your network now works. But you should be able to ping every address at that point that's in this addressing table from wherever. You should be able to ping it from the switch, from the router, or from the PC. All right, I hope this helps move you guys along a little bit. A little late coming to you, but hopefully this will help if you've already been struggling a bit. And I'm going to take a look at a couple of other labs to see if a short video like this will help get you moving along with those as well. All right, email or a text or call, however how you can get in touch with me. Any questions? Very good. All right, thanks, and I'll see you guys next time.